Welcome to Ayurvedic Pathshala. If you like the videos, hit like and subscribe and keep watching.
Hello everyone, today I am going to discuss with you about a very important topic of our subject, that is care of newborn. In Ayurveda we call this Navjat Shishu Paricharya, and this topic is very important from the point of view of examinations are concerned and from the practical point of view in the OPDs. We need this very much. We should be well aware about how a baby is cured. So talking about why there is need of care of newborn, as there were very much neonatal mortality rate earlier. What is neonatal mortality rate? It is the number of neonatal deaths per 1000 live births. So to reduce that neonatal mortality rates, or to reduce the number of deaths of newborns, it was very important to have a basic newborn care at least at every health service center, and it should be highly cost effective so that all the population can afford it easily. So basic components that were included in care of newborn were four. One is good quality antenatal care. If the 9 months of period of a mother and a baby is very healthy and good, then the outcome will also be very healthy and good. Second, safe delivery and optimal care at birth. We should encourage hospital deliveries for safe and infection-free deliveries, and to avoid any kind of complications after deliveries. So we should encourage hospital deliveries, and there should be proper care at the time of birth of a baby. Third very important point is promotion of exclusive breastfeeding. We should encourage exclusive breastfeeding to the mother so that baby should have proper nutrition, because only mother milk is the complete food for a newborn baby, and it should be encouraged till 6 months of age. So mother should be properly counseled, family should be properly counseled about the benefits of breastfeeding, and to encourage exclusive breastfeeding, that is only and only breast milk. Fourth very important is prevention and early treatment of hypothermia and bacterial infections. As newborn babies sometimes are born very early, or that is premature, or sometimes are postmature. But premature babies or normal babies, sometimes they have very less brown fat in their body, and brown fat leaves so very much amount of energy in the body, large amount of energy in the body, and providing heat to the baby. But when there is lack of brown fat, so baby will lose its body heat early and can land into hypothermia, and then it can result in multiple problems to the baby, like respiratory distress, shock, and even death. So we have to prevent hypothermia at early stages, and also bacterial infections, because sepsis can lead to trouble to the baby. Based upon the birth weight of the babies and the gestational age, or the age at which they are born, there is three-tiered system of neonatal care which is prepared: level 1, level 2, and level 3. Level 1 is the minimum care system. Here most of the babies, almost 80% of the newborn babies, require only minimal care, as they are very active at the time of birth. There are very less chances that there are emergencies, but when they occur, they can create problems to the patient, to the mother, and to the physician as well. So we have to be very much prepared for all deliveries. So almost 80% of the newborns, they need very minimum type of care, and the neonates included in level 1 care are with the weight of more than 1800 grams and with the gestational age of more than 34 weeks. Here the care given can be provided at home, at sub-center, or at primary health centers. Here the basic care at birth is given. There should be provision of warmth, maintenance of asepsis, and promotion of breastfeeding to the baby, and we will discuss about the basic care at birth in the coming lecture. Level 2 care includes only 10 to 15% of the babies. They require level 2 care, and the babies included in this are of the birth weight 1200 to 1800 grams and the gestational age of 30 to 34 weeks. As they are very low in birth weight and gestational age, they require trained nurses and pediatricians for their care. There should be equipment of resuscitations, as early born babies are sometimes so premature that their lungs are even not mature to respire. So sometimes we need equipment for resuscitation. We need maintenance of thermoneutral environment to protect the baby from hypothermia, and also we should have other things like phototherapy, gavage feeding, exchange blood transfusion kind of facilities to tackle with the complications that a baby can land into. Level 3 care is required to only 3 to 5% of the babies. It is a kind of intensive care, so we need NICU for this thing. That is, neonatal intensive care unit is required for level 3 care. And the babies weighing less than 1200 grams and gestational age of less than 30 weeks are included in this type of care. And this care can only be given in the large institutions or apex institutions or the regional perinatal centers where there is complete equipment present inside the hospital, including centralized oxygen, suction facilities, phototherapy, blood transfusion, incubators, transcutaneous monitors and ventilators to keep the baby. So what is the basic care that has to be followed for a baby after birth in the labor room? Before every delivery, we should be well aware of the fact that any delivery can lead into emergency. For that, we should have a birth resuscitation kit with us and a radiant heat warmer should be properly checked. And a birth resuscitation kit includes a mucus suction machine, laryngoscope, laryngeal blades, ambu bag, mask, torch, corrugator tube, ET tubes, that is endotracheal tubes, oxygen supply, nasogastric tubes, suction catheters, all these has to be there. All the injections like adrenaline, normal saline for volume expanders, then sodium bicarbonate for acidosis, they all has to be available at that time. Very important thing that I'm going to talk about is the maintenance of 5 C's. To avoid any kind of septic infection, we have to maintain 5 C's, that is clean hands to hold the baby, clean delivery surface to keep the baby, clean cord cutter while cutting the cord, clean cord tie, that is cord clamp, should be very clean, and clean cord should be maintained to maintain the baby and to maintain sepsis at that time. Next important thing that has to be remembered is Apgar scoring system, which was given by Virginia Apgar in 1952, and he made the mnemonic on the basis of his surname Apgar, where A stands for appearance, P for pulse rate, G for grindness, A for activity and R for respiration. And the scoring is given 0, 1, 2 and is assessed at 1 minute and 5 minutes after birth. The maximum scoring is 10 and the minimum scoring is 0 for this particular thing. Appearance, if appearance is blue or pale, then the score is given 0. If body is pink and extremities are blue, then the score is given 1. If the appearance is completely pink, then the score is given 2. Pulse rate, talking about pulse rate or heart rate, if it is absent, then the score is given 0. And if heart rate is less than 100 beats per minute, then the score is given 1. If the heart rate is more than 100 beats per minute, that is normal considered, and the score is given 2. Grimace, if there is no sneeze or cough just after birth, then the score is given 0. If there is some grimace, then the score is given 1. And if cough or sneeze is present, then the score is given 2. Talking about activity of the baby, baby is generally in the flexion position just after birth. If the baby is totally flaccid, there is no activity in the limbs, then the score is given 0. If the baby is in flexion, then the score is given 1. And if there are active movements or baby is in highly flexion position, then the score is given 2. Respiration of a newborn baby is assessed on the basis of the cry. If respiration is absent, then the score is given 0, or cry is absent, then the score is given 0. If there is weak cry, then the score is given 1. And if there is strong cry, then the score is given 2, with a total score of 10 and the minimum score of 0. And the score of 7 to 10 is considered good. Talking about cord clamping, so what is cord clamping? Here the cord is clamped just after baby is delivered, and it has not to be a very hasty process. It should not be very immediate or nor be very deliberate. So adverse effects of early cord clampings include hypovolemia, hypoxia, decrease in heart preload, increases peripheral vascular resistance. But there are some conditions when cord clamping can also have good effects. Delayed cord clamping in preterm infants can result in fewer babies needing transfusion for anemia, circulatory stability, intraventricular hemorrhage is reduced, There is reduced late onset sepsis. There can be reduced risk of necrotizing enterocolitis if we follow delayed cord clamping in preterm infants. Second important thing after cord clamping is that we have to shift the baby to the mother's abdomen or keep the baby warm. 90% of the babies which are born, they are vigorous at the time of birth. There are no risk factors and normally the amniotic fluid is also clear. In this condition, we have to place the baby on the mother's abdomen or chest. If the delivery is normal delivery, in case of C-section or cesarean, we can place the baby under radiant heat warmer directly. There we have to clean the mouth and nose of the baby with the suction catheter, which we call Mukh Vishodhan in Ayurveda, and we dry the baby with pre-warm linen. We have to completely dry him to prevent from hypothermia, as wet body can lead to more heat loss to the environment. So we have to dry the baby as quick as possible. After covering the baby with dry warm linen, we go for cord cutting. Or you can also shift the baby to the picture shown here, that is radiant heat warmer, and examine the baby from head to toe and watch all the vitals, breathing, heart rate, color, muscle tone, activity, and assess the Apgar score, which has to be calculated at 1 minute and 5 minutes of birth. Next very important thing is cord care. After stabilizing the baby, which we have done after keeping the baby in radiant heat warmer and assessing the baby's vitals, we go for cord care. There we apply two ligatures on the cord and one ligature has to be tied at 2 cm from the abdomen of the baby. And we cut in between the two ligatures applied. There we check for the anatomy of the cord. If there is presence of two arteries and one umbilical vein or not. If there is one missing umbilical artery or only presence of one artery, it shows towards or it points towards congenital anomalies to the patient or the baby. So we have to check the cut end of the baby for the cut end of the cord for the anatomy of the umbilical cord. Once cord is cut, it should be left dry and open and we should apply nothing on the cord. Next important is vitamin K prophylaxis. It is given in the labor room to the baby, where injection vitamin K is given intramuscularly at the anterolateral aspect of the thigh. If the baby is more than 1 kg, then 1 mg of vitamin K is given, and if baby is less than 1 kg, then 0.5 mg of vitamin K is given, and it is given to check the hemorrhagic disorders of the newborn. This care we have already discussed is about the vigorous babies or the babies which were active at the time of birth. If the baby is not active at the birth, or if there is breathing problem to the baby, or if the breathing is not established and the baby is in fetal distress or birth asphyxia, then what we do? Initially, you should know what is birth asphyxia first of all. Birth asphyxia is something when there is lack of oxygen inside the body. When there is lack of oxygen, it will lead to hypoxia. Hypoxia condition, in this condition, we are not able to expirate total CO2 present in the blood. In that case, CO2 starts accumulating inside the blood and we land into hypercapnia. And ultimately then hypoperfusion and then lowering of pH and we land into respiratory acidosis. In this condition, baby has gasping or inadequate breathing, or there will be no breathing for at least 1 minute. This is birth asphyxia. In this condition, firstly, we provide the warmth and position the baby properly. Provide the warmth, we take the baby under a radiant heat warmer to keep the baby warm, and do not cover it with the clothes or blankets because we have to examine the baby in all through process whether he is okay or not. If we cover the baby, it will hinder our examination process, and then we position the baby properly on its back with neck slightly extended. For this, for extension of neck, we put a 1-inch shoulder pillow below the shoulders of the baby. Here is the picture that is showing the proper extension of the neck. Here this picture shows proper extension of the neck. We place the pillow under the shoulders and extend the neck of the baby. This is the hyperextension. We should avoid this. And legs extension or under extension should also be avoided. Second important thing is clear the airway. After proper extension, airway is open. Then we go for clearing the airway, and it depends on the presence or absence of meconium. For that, you should know what is meconium first of all. Meconium is a stool of the baby, you can say. Meconium is a dark green, sticky, thick fecal material produced in the intestine, made up of cells, proteins, fats, and intestinal secretions. So it is very bad from the point of view of its two properties. One, it is thick, and second, it is sticky. Sometimes baby aspirates this meconium and it sticks into the lungs of the baby or into the trachea. And because of its sticky property, it is also very difficult to remove this meconium from the respiratory pathway. If there is no meconium, if baby is normal and there is no meconium, still baby is in distress, first we go for mouth and nose cleaning, which we have already discussed, and the catheter we use is 12 or 14 FR under pressure 80 to mm of Hg. Suction catheter should be inserted first into the mouth, then into the nose, and in nose when we insert up to 3 cm and in mouth we insert up to 5 cm. And we go for intermittent suctioning. It is not a continuous process, and we suction for a maximum of 15 seconds. Then we turn the baby to lateral side. In case if there are some secretions, they drool out from the side of the mouth or the corner of the mouth. So as we have already dried the baby and repositioned the baby, we go for stimulation of the baby. Drying the baby is the first stimulation that we give as a tactile stimulus while cleaning the baby and covering it with pre-warmed linen. Second stimulus we can give is in the form of tactile stimulation by rubbing the back and flicking the soles of the baby. If the baby cries at this time, then well and good, otherwise we go for higher resuscitation process. This is the resuscitation chart that we follow for resuscitating the baby or for reviving the baby. After birth, if we see that the meconium is clear, after birth, if we see that the meconium is clear and baby is crying and breathing properly, right, and there is a proper Apgar score is proper, good muscle tone is there, color is pink, and baby is term gestation is also proper, then we go for proper routine care or regular care that we go for, that is, we provide warmth, clear the airway, dry the baby, and then hand over it to the mother. But if it is not there, if all these points are not there, there is no clear, or any one of them is missing, clear meconium is missing, crying is missing, good muscle tone is missing, or color is not pink at all, and baby is also preterm, then what we do? We provide warmth, that is a regular process. We clear the airway, which is also a regular process, and we stimulate the baby and reposition the baby that we have discussed in the earlier slide. And after that, we give oxygen if required. If the baby's heart rate, respiration rate, and color revives after providing oxygen and heart rate becomes more than 100 and body becomes thin, then we go for supportive care, that is regular care like. And if heart rate is more than 100 but baby is still cyanotic, that is baby is still blue, then we give more oxygen or supplemental oxygen. And if baby revives and baby becomes pink, then we again switch to supportive care. If after supplying oxygen, again baby is cyanosed, there is no recovery in cyanosis, and if heart rate is less than 100 and baby is in apnea condition, is not respiring properly, then we provide positive pressure ventilation. If after positive pressure ventilation, heart rate is more than 100 and baby is pain, it means ventilation was effective and we can go for regular care or post-resuscitation care. But if again heart rate is more than 60 and baby is not reviving, then we can administer chest compressions. If heart rate is less than 60 and baby is not reviving, then also we have to go for positive pressure ventilation and chest compressions. If after that also baby does not revive and heart rate again falls below 60, then we go for IV adrenaline shots or direct cardiac shots of adrenaline to revive the baby. If still baby does not revive, there may be some other pathology associated. There may be some congenital disorder or some other kind of pathology. We will discuss about resuscitation in our next videos in detail. Here I have just discussed an outline what we go for resuscitation, and it is a 90 seconds process, you should remember. So this was all regarding normal newborn care that we give in the labor room for a normal born baby and for a sick baby. And rest, if you like my videos, do like and subscribe this channel. Here is the link shown in this video, or you can also follow my other videos for the other lectures of this subject. Till then, take care.